Hey everybody, how's it going? And welcome to another MAMG Let's Play of Hotel Dusk. When we left off, we were just about to start Chapter 9, and we also found out that Rosa made a very, very big mistake when it came to Mila's father. Of course, Kyle knew what was going on, but yeah. We're going from 12 to 2 a.m. I have no idea what's supposed to happen in this chapter. Alright, I guess when I try to leave, the phone's gonna go off? No? Yes? What? Painting of an apple, huh? Rosa said there were 5 apple paintings. Should we look at them? Is that what you want me to do? Because I can. Alright, apple paintings right here. There's a painting on the wall. It's a still life. Okay. It's a painting of apples. Oh. Okay, puzzle time, I guess. Whoa. What am I doing? I'm supposed to find something in here? Okay. He's looking at the thing like super close. Supposed to be something here? Hidden in the painting? Can I click on anything? This is a very random way to start the episode. To say the least, what's that? There's a letter painted into the picture. Oh. Okay. A picture of 5 apples and the letter Y. Are we going apple hunting? There are other apple paintings besides this one. Okay, sounds like we're about to go apple painting hunting. Okay, I know there's one in, this hallway here. There's one downstairs, but are there any others in everybody else's room? Apple painting? Nope. Okay. Let's see, I think there's one down here. Yep, there's another apple painting. Okay, what about you? So this one's got 2. There's a painting on the wall, it's still life. Yep, again, with the apples, but this one only has 2 apples. So maybe that's like the position of the letter? That's how many... T? Is that not it? Am I just seeing stuff now? Okay. Where else is there? I'm guessing it doesn't have to be on the apple, it could be anywhere. Who went through all the time to do this? Oh, there's an E. Picture 2 apples and the letter E. Okay, I don't know why you're doing your notes the way that you are. But, you go for it, buddy. Okay, so there's one more downstairs. Yeah, right here. Straight back. So why is my hotel room the only one that has, like, one in the room itself? That's weird. Okay, so this one's got 3 apples on it. And what letter are we gonna find on it? Okay, searching. N, right there. Boom. Easy peasy. Okay, so I have no idea where the other ones are. I think there's one maybe like where the bar area is. Maybe. But why am I doing this? What's the point of it? What's it gonna solve? We don't even know what it's a password to, honestly. Apple painting? No. Is there one in the restaurant? Probably not. Okay. Well, I guess it's time for me to search around and see if I can find one. Although, I bet you the lobby has one, because I mean, that's what you think, right? Like, nice art in the lobby? There's gotta be one in the lobby. And I think they told us there were 5 in total. That would make the most sense. Okay, so nothing here. Front desk. I don't see any paintings. There's no apple paintings. Alrighty, I hope I don't have to go into, like, people's rooms. Just hear knock on the door and be like, excuse me, do you have an apple painting in your room? If so, let me in, because I want to see what's on it. okay, can I go through here? Is there one in here anywhere? Nope. Yeah, I'm gonna have to wander. Ah, here's another one in 217, that's right. In this room here, there was one on the bottom, and we had to search for the, well, we found like a picture or something down here, right? Yeah, right here. Okay. Let me check out this one. Does it have an apple? Let's see. Yes, it does. It's got four apples. Okay. So, where are you with the lettering? Come on, it can't be that hard to find. Where is it? Where is it? There it is. Another N. Okay. A picture of four apples and the letter N. So we have N-E-Y-N. This is the fourth apple painting I've seen. I need to find one more. Okay. I'm guessing since it popped up as a question, we need to either talk to Rosa or Louie. And maybe find out where the last one is? Because apparently that's all the ones that Kyle knows of too, which I only knew three of the four. Yo, hi! Ah, sweet, Louie, yes! It's gotta be Louie, right? That's you, Louie? Where you been, man? I've been all over this place trying to track you down. I finally found Mila down in Rose's room. He's still looking for her. Looks like someone found her and let her there, yeah? Man, you should have said something. Make me waste all my time like that. I was looking for her too, you know? Sorry. Nah, I get it. Just forgot all about old Louie again, huh? Nah, I see what it is. Oh, look at that, poor Louie. Knock it off, Louie. I got some new info. About Mila? It's about her father. Seems her old man went missing 7 years ago. Trip, man. That's a long time to be off the map. So, what? Mila's been looking for her pops this whole time? Maybe. Something rough happened to her, but I don't know the full story. I have to poke around some more. Yeah, well, check this. I got some info too. It's about that old king. Ooh, yes, please tell me. Oh, and also did that B&E that you wanted to find out about Melissa's mom. Looked up the guest book from 2 years back. Awesome, now we're getting somewhere. Okay, cool. Where's the apple painting? Just point me to the apple paintings. What? Those crappy things? Man, what do you want to know about those for? Just a hunch I need to check. Rosa said there were five paintings, but I can only find four. Apples, huh? You sure you ain't been hitting the bourbon again, Hyde? Okay, let me think. You got the second floor hallway. Yeah, in your room too. You remember that one? I saw those. There's also one in 217 and one at the end of the central hallway. Oh, right. Yeah, let me see. Nah, man, sorry. I don't know about that last one. Well, that sucks. Alright, what else you got? So what's that key for? It's the key for the booze cellar. And are you thinking what Louie's thinking? Probably not. I guess I had to try, yeah? Anyways, this is the one key old man Dunning never let me touch. Didn't even keep a copy with those other keys, what he keeps in the office. But man, hiding it inside a plant? Never would have guessed. What a trip. Yeah, it's odd. It really is. For the cellar? So, was Grace here 2 years ago? See, that's the thing, man. I don't know. Guest logs in the office only go back 1 year. I got no idea if he tossed the old ones or what. Gotcha. So hey, Hyde. You gonna go scope out that booze cellar? Yeah. Well, just hurry up before Dunning finds out you have that key. Dig? Listen, I gotta swing over to Seven Stars and close up shop. I'll come down to the cellar after one. Dig? Louis. Aw, crap, man. What in the Sam Hill are you doing here? You're supposed to be minding the bar. I'm going, Mr. Smith. I'm on my way. Then get to it. Thought I could trust you with watching my bar. Don't make me regret it. Yes, sir. I'm going. Louis runs down the hall. Dang kid. Got a whole lot of learning to do. I'm sorry you had to hear all that, Mr. Hyde. Don't worry about me. Well, ain't you just a big sweetheart? But tell me something, Mr. Hyde. Why you talking to Louis at this hour anyway? Just bored. That's so. Well, alright then. Excuse me. Dunning stomps off down the hall. Okay? Okay, so we need to go... where? The cellar thing? I don't know. I don't know where I should go. Yeah, nothing over here, okay. Guess I'm just gonna have to wait and see what happens. So I'm not 100% sure. Something's supposed to trigger? Or maybe I haven't found, I haven't found Rosie yet either. I know she's in the linens closet though. Let's go downstairs to her room and maybe I can ask her. But I think my question prompt went away. Which is slightly bothersome as well. Anybody in here? Front desk? Nope. Okay. Yeah, so let's go ahead and see if Rose is home. She better be at this hour. Seriously. If you let Mila run away again, I'm done. I'm not even gonna look for her anymore. Not Dunning's room. Up here. Rose's room. Okay. Let me knock on this door. Rosa! At least she opened. Well, Mr. Hyde, what can I do for you? You got a minute? Of course. Okay, let's ask her about the painting. Have you learned anything about Mila's father? Huh? Well, have you? Also, I love the fact that one of you guys pointed out that her face is super creepy. Ugh, it's so disturbing when you just look at her face. Especially when it's smiling. Rosa, it's been about 20 minutes. I'm good, but not that good. Oh, yes. I suppose not. Well, I guess you just have to put on your sleuthing cap. But I may have one thing. Yes? Milo's father's a guy named Robert Evans. Robert Evans. Robert Evans. Oh my goodness. Oh my stars. Easy, Rosa. I take it you've heard of him. No, I'm just excited. Oh. So your father's name is Robert Evans, is it, Mila? I wonder where he could be. Aw, poor Mila. Never you fret, Mila, honey. Mr. Hyde is gonna find him for you. Right, Mr. Hyde?
Sure.
Alright, apple painting. Tell me where it's at. Listen. Where are those apple paintings you were talking about? You said there were five, right?
That's right.
Are there really five?
For a fact. This hotel isn't that big, you know, and I've counted them many times. Those paintings have been here as long as I have.
I guess you saw how each painting has a different number of apples.
Well, I was sure that had some kind of meaning, but darned if I know it.
I tried asking Mr. Smith about it once, but that man is just useless. Who knows, he told me.
I bet he knows, the old coot.
I don't know about that, but I did learn something else.
Truly? Ooh, tell Rosa. Come on now.
There's a hidden letter in each painting.
Letters? Goodness me.
I think those letters mean something. That's why I need to know where all the paintings are hung.
I see. Well, there are three on the second floor and two on the first floor, right?
Wait, there are two on the first floor?
Of course! There's the one in the hallway, and then... Oh, but you wouldn't know. You would know about the one in the special room.
Special room? What the heck does that mean?
You have a special room?
Okay, I'm curious. What's the special room?
It's at the back of the lobby. It's the only room like it in the entire hotel.
And that's where the fifth painting is.
That's right. It says room 111 on the door.
Can you get me into room 111?
So you can see the apple painting? Is that it? Well, I suppose so. Alright, but only for Mila. Oh, and because I'm a little bit curious too.
Thanks. I'm gonna have to sneak the key away from Mr. Smith.
Once I do that, I'll go into room 111 and wait for you. Then you can just slip in later, okay? Good.
Got it.
Mila is counting on you to figure this all out, so don't mess it up. And for mercy's sake, don't let Dunning know about any of this. Sneak around.
Rosa sneaks off down the hall. Okay. Now what? Should I ask Mila about her old man? Mila. Alright. Don't look at me like that. I'll just wait until I know what's what with those paintings. You coming along for the ride?
Oh, really?
Oh, God. Okay, so she's coming with me. They said we need to sneak around, so I'm gonna go ahead and save. Because I don't want to run into anything, any issues. Because I'm guessing, like, Dunning, like, he's always... Remember when he was patrolling the halls and he caught us and we got, like, an immediate game over? I'm guessing that's what's gonna happen if I'm not careful. Okay, so room 111, huh? You know what? She did say sneak around, so we're gonna go up to the second floor. And we're gonna go down. I don't know if it's really gonna help any, but whatever. At least I tried, okay? Lobby? Are you here? Rosa!
Psst! Psst!
Knocking's not getting me anywhere. Probably not. Door? Okay, we're in. Sweet! Oh, there she is. Well, I knocked! I mean, it's rude to, you know, just break into somebody's house.
So you managed to avoid Mr. Smith, did you?
Oh, so I bet you if I did go straight out, then he was gonna find me. Oh, sneaky, sneaky. I'm sneaky when I need to be.
I don't doubt it. The apple painting is in the back. Go on now.
I'm on it.
I'm just gonna wait here with Mila, if that's all right by you.
Sure. Okay, so in the back. In here? Just go in. Come on. Apple painting. Where? Oh, there it is. Okay, I see it. I see it. Right here. What do you know? It's a still life painting. One apple. It's an apple painting. Okay, so since we have two N's, an E, and a Y, I'm guessing it's like a name like Jenny or Penny or Kenny or Benny. I don't know. There's a lot. Oh, it's Jenny. Okay, cool.
Who's Jenny?
A picture of an apple and the letter J. Yeah, see, J-E-N-N-Y. I think that's what it's supposed to spell. That's all of the hidden letters. I wonder what they mean. Probably Jenny. Yeah. I mean, what else would it be?
Jenny.
If I arrange them in the order of the number of the apples in each painting, it spells Jenny.
Jenny.
Wait, I've seen that name before. It was on the birthday card I found in Dunning's office. Ooh. I don't know, guys. I'm really starting to think that he's the painter. Because, like, it makes the most sense. Ah!
What now?
What? Whoa, what did you do, Rosa?
Mila. Mila. Oh, Mila. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear, oh no. What do we do? What do we do? She's not breathing. I can't hear her.
What?
Do something. Do something, Mr. Hyde. Help the poor girl. Help Mila.
I don't, what do you want me to do? Poke her nose?
You've got to put your face next to hers, Mr. Hyde.
Do I need to close it again? Hang on. That's weird. Okay, yeah, because putting my face next to unconscious girls always wakes them up. Actually, that's really weird for a number of reasons. But anyways, yeah, apparently I wanted you to close the DS. You okay?
Yes. Whoa, she spoke!
What the? We put power into her vocal cords.
Mila? Don't.
I'm sorry, what?
Take Jenny.
Holy crap, she's talking.
Mila. Dear, your voice. I. Oh, what a blessing. This is a true miracle. Mila, you can speak again. Your voice has returned.
Mila.
I.
You okay? What's wrong?
I remember. I remember. I remember. It all went dark. Just like that one time. Mila? Sweetie. Dear, how did you lose your voice? It's okay. You can tell Rosa.
Mila? Hey, take it easy. Just tell me what happened. Interesting. She speaks! Okay, what do you remember? What do you remember?
I was playing with her in this room.
This room? You've been here before.
Yes.
Are you sure?
Please, dear, answer Mr. Hyde.
Who were you playing with in here?
Jenny.
Which is Dunning's daughter.
I was with Jenny. I was waiting for Papa.
So many questions, they're just like filling up the screen. What do you mean when you said, like that time?
That time everything went dark.
It went dark?
When I was waiting for Papa.
Mila, when was this?
When I was 9.
So how old are you now?
Mila, answer him. How old are you? 19. That's what they said.
Someone had to tell you?
Who? Who said that?
What happened, Mila?
I don't know. It was because I was over there for a long time.
How did you lose your voice?
I was scared. Jenny was crying. Jenny said, "Help me." I was scared.
Who's Jenny?
A girl. A friend I met here. My friend. Papa said stay and wait with Jenny. So we played. But Jenny, she...
Someone took her, didn't they? Who was it?
A man. A strange man with a scary face.
Okay? Mila, where is your father?
I don't know. The gallery was gone, so we came here. Papa and me came here.
How long have you been looking for him?
A long time. Ever since I woke up. A long time.
You said you were over there. Where is that?
Robin's hospital? I woke up. I was in a bed. And no one was there. So I tried to call for Papa. But I couldn't speak. And your mother? Sweetie, where was she during all this? Mom wasn't there. She was in a crash. A plane crash. I waited for Papa for a long time. But Papa never came. So
you came here. Interesting. Yeah, when did you wake up? When did you wake up?
Don't know. I was asleep. For a long time. Then they told me I just woke up. Oh, Mila. You poor, poor girl.
She's gone through a lot.
You must be tired. Let's get you back to Rosa's room. It's okay. I'm gonna take good care of you. Mr. Hyde, I'm going to see to it that this little girl gets the rest she needs. You'll have to ask her about your paintings later.
Why not? Nothing else has gone according to plan tonight. Mila and Rosa leave. We should probably leave too. Actually, let me save again in case Dunning's like waiting out there. Crazy man that he is. Okay, so Mila was, it looks like she was in a coma or something. Cause like, she said that they told her she was 19. That's insane. So crazy. Mr. Hyde? I'm sorry, I couldn't sleep and I overheard. Oh, hi! Hey, Doc. How's the night treating you? I've felt better, but I think the worst is over. At least, I hope. Yeah, me too. Did something happen? You seem tired. I am tired, but I'll live. In that case, can I trouble you for a moment? I need to ask you something. I'm not loaning you money. You just came out of room 111, right?
Yeah.
You saw me do it.
What of it?
Well, were you with her?
With who?
The woman. The young woman in white. She just came out of that room with the maid.
You mean Mila?
Mila. That's it. That was her name.
What's your story?
You don't like her name? Yeah, it's a stupid name. No, it's not. It's an adorable name.
You know something? Spill it.
Yes, I just remembered something when I heard her name. Her name is Mila Evans.
Okay, so you know that.
Yeah, how do you know Mila?
Everybody knows everybody in this freaking hotel. Oh, jeez.
How do you know her?
She was a patient at the hospital where I worked.
Interesting.
Yes. Robin's memorial in Santa Monica. But I never expected to see her here. Not at all.
So maybe she was in a coma, like comatose manner state, when she was there?
What was she doing in the hospital?
It's an odd case. She was brought to us unconscious with no visible injuries. She spent almost the next 10 years in a coma.
Yeah.
10 years?
That's a long time to be in the dark.
It sure is. We didn't see any sign of hope, but then half a year ago, she just came around. The attending physician was astonished. He called her recovery a miracle. Not that I take stock in such things. But unfortunately, we had trouble contacting her family.
Then let me ask you something. Do you know her family? You know anything about her family? Yes. Oh, please spill it. Her father used to come in once a month and check in on her progress. His visits were like clockwork. He came once a month for 10 years. Without fail. But for some reason, he never appeared after she woke up. Sounds like he picked a bad time to hang it up.
Yes, perhaps. We tried several times to contact him, but he never returned our calls.
Oh, and the bills. The bills had all been paid in advance. No one ever came to see her besides her father. He may have no idea what has happened.
You ever meet her, old man?
No, I heard about it from the nurses and such.
Right.
Oh, and Mr. Hyde? I just remembered something else, if you can spare a moment.
Go ahead.
Do you remember the first time we met this evening? When I thought I heard your name before. I just remembered why. I don't know how I missed it, but, well, anyway. Right before Mila woke up, she had a new visitor.
Keep talking, Doc.
His name... The name of that visitor was Kyle Hyde.
Oh, you're kidding me.
When we couldn't reach Mila's father, we thought... I mean, the hospital, they tried to notify this Hyde fellow, but to no avail. Mr. Hyde, did you visit Mila before she woke up?
Wasn't me.
I see. Well, please keep an eye on her. And try to keep her from overdoing it.
I can't imagine she has fully recovered her strength yet.
Excuse me.
Kevin leaves the lobby. So that's why she can't talk, her vocal cords are shot.
So Kevin knew about Mila.
And Mila came out of a coma 6 months ago. And somebody named Kyle Hyde visited her. Could that have been you, Bradley? Pager, huh?
Phone call!
Maybe it's figured out something else.
This is gonna be a long chapter. It's still 12:40. We have to make it to 2 a.m.
Alright, let's go ahead and go upstairs and see what Ed wants.
Ed! Oh, my friend Ed.
Alrighty.
Hopefully he's got some good news. Although, I seem to doubt it too. I guess I should give Ed a ring. Rachel, you still there?
Nope. Hi, what's the good word?
What, no Rachel?
Everybody's gotta go home sometime.
Listen, I just heard a little chestnut about Evans.
You heard a chestnut? You sitting down? I am, he's not.
10 years ago, Robert Evans bought himself a little place called Hotel Dusk.
Robert Evans bought this hotel?
Yeah, seems Evans bought the thing in 1969. He owned it for 3 years, then sold it to some mope for a song.
So he sold it 7 years ago.
You must be tired, Hyde. You're repeating everything. Anyway, he sold it to Dunning Smith. You probably met him by now. I don't know what you found here, Hyde, but that place is a troubled history.
Tell me.
Dust used to be a real party joint, but in 1969, it just shut down. You follow me?
Means Evans shut the place down the moment he bought it.
Now, why the hell would a guy do a thing like that? Who buys a business just to shut it down? And why'd he sell it to Dunning Smith?
My thinking is that Evans played Smith and dumped the place, but I don't know.
Lots of questions here, Hyde. You might not like where this night of sleuthing ends up.
I'd get ready for a bad surprise.
Thanks, Ed.
What? Who's that?
You got visitors at this hour? You're busier than I thought.
Looks like it.
Well, I'll leave you to it. Watch your back.
Who's knocking on my door? It's midnight. Don't knock on my door at midnight.
Yeah? Is it Louis? Oh, it's Rosa. Oh, Rosa. Now what?
Oh, Mr. Hyde, it's just terrible.
Rosa, pull yourself together. What's going on?
It's Mila.
What about her?
She hasn't come back. He came and took her and she hasn't come back. Mr. Smith came and took her away.
Dunning?
Yes, I was trying to take Mila back to my room, you know? And then Mr. Smith just came out of nowhere. He told me to take Mila to the police first thing in the morning. But then I told him. Oh, what a fool thing I did. I told him she could speak, and that we knew why she had come here. Then he said there was no need to call the police at all. And then he said that he was going to have a little chat, and he took her away.
Wait, he took her?
Yes. Oh, what's going on?
Where are they?
I figured they went back to his room. But no one answers when I knock, and... What should I do, Mr. Hyde?
Go back to your room and sit still. I'll go find them.
All right, if you say so.
Rosa turns and scurries off down the hall. Dunning and Mila are having a chat, huh? I guess I should try his room first. Dunning, what you up to, buddy, huh? You sneaky, sneaky little man. So you bought the hotel from Mila's father. So you know who Mila is. Oh, no, I'm going the right way. I thought I was going the wrong way for a second. We need to go to the right hallway. Alrighty. What is the deal with this? So much going on. Okay, Dunning's room. Here we go. Yo, hi! Huh? Hi, Louie.
Louie.
I just got done talking to Mama Sass, my man. Heard the boss man came and took your new friend away, yeah? That's cold. I was about to check his room. Better you than me, my brother. But I got your back if you need it. Otherwise, I'll swing around the hotel and see what I can find. Wait, Louie, what about the wine cellar? Nah, man. I ain't been in there yet. Check it out. I'll swing by once I take a buzz through Dunning's room. Whatever you say, officer. Louie runs off. But he can't be in the cellar if, we have the one and only key, right? Okay, so why are we in here? What am I looking for? No one here. So he left this place completely open. What a silly, goofy little man. What am I looking for, though? It's a sports page. Okay. Anything else? The tablecloth looks like stars and stripes. Which is wonderful. Absolutely wonderful, but... should we look at this picture again? Maybe? It's a picture. Yeah, I know. There's a little girl in this photo. Yeah, it's Jenny. That's all we can do. Okay, so what's over here? I don't think we got in here yet. Okay, at least it's open. Okay, so what you got on your desk, Dunning? There are a lot of newspaper clippings on the wall in front of the desk. Okay, there's a brochure on the desk. Hotel brochure on top of the desk. Yeah, I know. This brochure. This is the same brochure Mila was carrying. The one from 10 years ago. Why would Dunning have one of these too? What's this? There's something written here. Oh! It's a sketch of a wine cellar with some kind of symbol on it. Okay, got the old brochure that was on the desk. Alright, what about this? The date of the paper is 1972, 7 years ago. The article reads, Osterzone's works, while smaller pieces, feature a distinctive expression. Light and shadow are used in a way beyond that of any other contemporary artist. Overflowing with the sensibility that is subtle yet bold, these canvases charm easily.
They can also capture the purest essence of a thing in a single fleeting moment. Most notably, the work Angel Opening a Door is a masterpiece. It so opens ambiguities in the viewer's power of imagination that even a layman can... Nice 50 cent words, pal. I wonder if Summer wrote this. But why would Dunning keep a newspaper article about ostracism? Okay. Looks like it's it for here. What's this? Yeah, what's that? Looks like some kind of wood carving. Okay. Anything else? There's some books stacked on the desk. No, can't do anything with that. Okay. What about this picture here? Yeah, that one. It's a picture of Dunning and a young girl. It's a big bookshelf. Okay. I don't know if there's anything else I can do. Upholstered chair in front of the desk. What about the drawers? There's something in the drawer here. There's a bunch of birthday cards in the drawer. I've seen this card before. There was one just like it in the office. Happy birthday, Jenny. The cards are all addressed to Jenny. What does this mean? I don't know, but the music stopped. Okay. There it goes again. There's nothing in the drawer. Okay. Well, I guess I looked at everything I need to. This has got something over here, which it doesn't look like he does. I think I got everything I need. I think. So we've already been in here. What's over here? Where are Dunning and Mila? And what could that symbol written on the old brochure mean? I need to figure this out, and fast. Okay. Where's the wine cellar, though? Louis has the key to the wine cellar. Is it over by the bar? It would have to be, right? That'd be the most logical place to put a wine cellar would be for the bar. Yeah, let's go this way. And let me see if I can... I remember seeing a cellar or anything in here. Louis's not here. Okay. I guess I don't need anything then. Wine cellar, wine cellar. Is it past the pantry? Maybe? Because there's another door here. What are you? Could Mila and Dunning be here? Why are we fading? Whoa, what? Once I heard about the apple paintings from Rosa, I decided to have a look. There were five in all, two on the first floor and three on the second. I found one on the second floor paintings in the hallway. And I found another in my room. The last one on the second floor was in... 217. We're already recapping the chapter? That's right. The last second floor apple painting was in room 217. I found five apple paintings in all. Why are we recapping now? Each painting had a different letter hidden on it. I had Rosa open room 111 so I could look at the final painting. Then, I rearranged the letters that I found in each of the paintings. Had to mix them up so they matched the number of apples in the paintings. When I finished, they spelled out the name Helen. No, Jenny. That's right. They spelled the name Jenny. Once I solved the puzzle, I went back to Mila and Rosa. I found Mila on the floor. Her breathing had stopped, so I had to give her mouth to mouth. You had to. When she came to, Mila was able to start talking. I grilled her for a bit and learned a few things. Like that she had been to this dump before with her father. When they came here, Mila was... 9. 33 years old? Good God. That's right. Mila was 9 years old when she came here with her old man. She made friends with a girl named Jenny. Guess the shock of seeing Jenny get abducted put Mila in a coma. Mila went under when she was just 9 years old. And she was in that coma for a long time. Kevin told me he knew her from his time at the hospital, where she stayed. And the name of that hospital was... Robbins. Whew, okay, good. I was like, Red Crown's where he works. She went to Robbins Memorial Hospital in Santa Monica. She only woke out of that coma 6 months ago. When Mila regained her voice, some of these mysteries started making sense. Then, Ed came and told me about the hotel's previous owner. Seems Robert Evans bought the place 10 years back, and then dumped it on Dunning. Then, Rosa showed up, and told me that Dunning had taken off with Mila. Dunning wasn't in his room, but I tossed the place anyway. I found something in his desk drawer. It was... we found an old pamphlet and that was in the drawer. Okay, the drawer itself. Yep, got it. Because the other two were on the desk. That's right. I found a whole bunch of birthday cards. They were all addressed to Jenny. When I saw them all together like that, I figured it out. Jenny is the name of Dunning's daughter, the one Rosa told me about. How do Dunning and Evans tie together? What kind of shady dealings were they up to? Evans and Mila, Dunning and Jenny. Two men and their daughters. And what about Kyle Hyde? What about Kyle Hyde that paid Mila a visit? Was that you, Bradley? Outside, in the LA night, the worst side of humanity has a license to roam. And here, I'm inside this hotel. Am I gonna find something that I don't want to see? I guess it doesn't matter. I'm getting close to the truth, Bradley. And to you.
Is that the end of the chapter? Like, for real? What the? Louis! Dude, Louis, what happened? Hey! Slap him! What happened? Oh, snap! Oh, snap! Well, unfortunately, I'm gonna have to leave this episode here. I did try to make it a little bit longer so that, we could go ahead and, you know, catch back up, because the other two videos have been a little bit shorter lately, but, man, that's crazy. So we must be in chapter 10 now. Yeah, that was chapter 9, so chapter 10 is the final chapter. That's why it's 2 a.m., because we were unconscious. Oh my god! Okay, so I don't know if we'll be able to finish it in the next episode. If chapter 10 is the shortest chapter 9 was, then yeah, maybe we will. Otherwise, I may break it apart. But for now, thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know if you enjoyed. I'll see you guys on the next MAMJ. Let's play. Yo, Hyde. Did you figure stuff out and bust heads and all that cop stuff? Come on, man. Hit me. What's the deal with the tape? The tape was sent to Iris by a woman named Grace. Grace? Yo, should I know this Grace or what? She's Iris' sister. Iris has a sister? Seriously? Ah, woo! You're a moron, Louis. There's more. Grace is Melissa's mother. Ah, woo, huh? No joke.